Is this thing on? Yep, good. Okay. I'm just fucking with you. I knew it was on. Anyway. It's nearly 2 o'clock in the afternoon, as you can see. And I've decided, as it's been typical British weather today, in the sense that it's pissing it down again, no surprise there. Canada gets snow in spring. We get rain all year round. Just rain. I can hear you, but will I be able to see you? Are you coming past? It's surprising how regularly I see an ambulance come past. Anyway, I've decided I'm gonna get these forks dropped out of this frame because they've got to be replaced anyway. I'm gonna see what that setup looks like. So I've been down at the shed as well. Not only did I take some photographs of bikes I want that I've put up for sale, I grabbed the hacksaw because I'm gonna need it, and some stems. Or more so, I needed these. I actually found another Claud Butler one, which might go better on the stem, because I'd like to use that if I can. But as this stem is seized into there, there's a very little chance of me freeing it off. I know from experience, which is why I'm not going to bother. It's not worth the hassle, as I'm replacing everything anyway. These. I'll put those in my back pocket, then I'll probably forget they're there. I was actually looking for a 5mm hexagon key that I had last night. Oh well, I'll just have to fish one out of the toolbox. I was just hoping it would save the hassle of fishing one out of here. But, nope. Here it is. Because before I start hacking through this, I'll take this bolt out. It's a 5mm, isn't it? Yeah. Oh, is that a 6mm then? Well, 6mm doesn't appear to be in here though. Where is that one? Oh, it is a 6mm. Well, that's peculiar. I just heard the little bit drop off. I'm going to reuse that as well, because that's in good condition. So, I need to prop this up on something away from this desk. Because what I'm going to do, I'm going to have to cut through here. If I had an angle grinder, a little one, and the electricity outside, I'd have done it with that. But I have neither. So, I've got a big ass angle grinder, but that's a bit too big for this. That'd be a bit overkill. Besides, I can cut through them pretty quick with this anyway. Right, so I'm going to go ahead and do that. If I had something I could put the camera on, so you could actually watch. What's it going to be like if I sit you on here? What's that? Works-ish, doesn't it? Right. Cool, yeah, that ain't moving. So, one axle, one stem. Thank you. good exercise. Me to get these nuts off. I think my blade might be getting a little bit blunt on that one. I've got another hacksaw somewhere, when I can remember what I did with it. Bitch, doesn't open quite far enough. Right, so what I'm going to have to do there is use a proper headstock spanner, wrong end. That really is good exercise. Cools down pretty quick as well. There we go. Can I do that one by hand? Yep. I'm just trying to see if there's anything I can just prop you on to tilt you a little bit. What about a piece of Lego? Still not quite tilted enough, is it? Alright then, two pieces of Lego. Where's that? Is that a bear? That's a bear. It's typical. Thinking I'm doing it by hand, and all I'm doing is moving the dust cover around. Have to reuse these bits, possibly. I'm gonna try to anyway, because it'll make life a bit easier. Okay. Drop those off. Now. Yay! I'm gonna hold those up there, roll that out of the way, in theory, try and lean that up somewhere without it going crash. That ain't gonna work, is it? Alright, I'm out on the floor. Grab the other pair of forks and slide those up. Just got to pop that wheel out of there. Can't find a 15mm. Well, I know that one isn't one. That one isn't one either. Both my 15mm have done a runner. Oh, I know where they are. In the bedroom when I put the wheels in the frame. Right, I'm just going to drop the wheel out of this. Oh, I'd even do this one up with spanner. I've just done them up finger tight. Ew, that would have been good if I went for a bike ride. Can't go for a bike ride on this anyway, but you know what I mean. Right, let's drop the wheel in here. So, make it a bit easier to work on. It's not looking too bad, to be honest. I want the bearing cone first, which is what this is. That's your bearing cone. It's got to go on. Well, actually, before I do that, I'm just going to lean this up. I'll just take a step back and we'll just have a look and see what this looks like. It's not actually looking too bad with those in, is it? Let's get the hole. Whoops, wrong way. Get the whole setup installed. Because it won't take a lot to swap them. Not at this stage anyway, because there's nothing else bolted to it. So, we'll get this in, we'll get the stem in. Might take a while to do this up because it's got quite a way to go down. So if I can actually no, it's just gonna keep sliding off, isn't it? Or is it? No. Even if I had a handlebar full of cables, it would be easy to swap the forks, because all I'd have to do is disconnect the V-brake from the forks, that's it. Nearly there, I think. That's alright. If I need to adjust the tension bearings, I can do. Now, this is a keyed washer. They only go on one way. There's a little notch just where my finger is. And that lines up with a groove on the steerer tube, like that. And then, of course, you have your lock nut. Which is just there to stop the cone from coming loose. I'm going to work on this one because there's too much thread. So, not to worry, I've got another little device over there that actually came with these forks. So, I'll take this one off. If I have to, if this what a thing doesn't work, then what I can do is just throw it across the floor like that. What I can do, what I think I will do actually, is put some spacers on there. I think my tub with my spacers in are in this closet. It's one of those ones. But I don't know which one. Which case is it? The top one. It is the top one. Right, and I'm going to want them in black. I've got a nice chunky one there. A thin one, I'll take that as well. Three should be more than enough. Should only need at least the one. Let's just have a look. I'll drop one on the top. Actually, this one might be enough. Nope. So I'm going to need another one. Take those off and I'll try that. Oops. Spacer. So that's worked. Right. Leave you like that. What's the next stop? Step rather, bring in the stem. Like so. Six mil hexagonal key. Should just hold that tight enough. What's that other CB cover? See if this one actually looks any better, because this top one's a bit wider than the bottom section. I don't really think it would notice by the time you've got the handlebar in, but I know it's there and that's enough to bug me. Right. Ooh, no, that one's, spacing for the nut holes is too wide for that one, so that's a no. What about, I've got another one here. I think I might just stick with this CB, to be honest. The one in my hand that I just took off. Yeah, because they're all going to be the same, even that one. Oh, well. One in, put that one in loose as well, so I don't lose them. Right, did I bring the handlebar in here? I thought I did. I thought I put that in here with the forks. Sure I did. Hang on, let me just check the bedroom for the handlebar. Not a lot of use on the bed, is it? Right, 5 mil. I don't want to use these shifters anyway, do I? So I can come off. Get off, you bastard. I haven't done anything super duper tight yet. Hang on. There we go. Put them in their level, that would help. You up again. I can lay that there, and I actually think I'm going to leave that set up in there, to be honest, because that looks all right. May lower the handlebar a bit, which is just a case of unscrewing the bolt through here and dropping it, which is why I haven't cranked those up, because that would then mean I've got to rotate these so they're still level. Yeah, I'm leaving those on there. I like that. So, actually worked better in there than I thought they would. I was going to go for black, but I don't want too much black. I love black. Love anything black, but it gets to a point where you can have too much black on something, so... I think those silver-coloured forks and handlebars will suit this nicely. So, that's that job for this one done. Right. What did I do with the other pair of V-brakes? Because they've got to go on. Found one. It's laying up here. What did I do with the other one? Do I leave it in here? Can't really miss it when it's that colour, can we? But it might be hiding somewhere. It might be under something. Might even be in the lounge, I don't know. May have actually, I think it is in here if I remember correctly. Find some nice clean bolts to bolt these on with. I'm going to have to loosen off the brake block as well. Well, I thought it was laying up here. I know it's laying in here somewhere. Come out, wherever you are, Mr. Brake. I know you're fucking in here somewhere. I'll find it later. I'll find it later. In the meantime, that is all for now. That's all, folks. No, not quite all. Let's get rid of these. I don't need these. Yeah, I do need these. I'm going to bin them. Keep hold of them. Right, I'm going to turn the camera off. Get the brakes actually bolted on now. And, don't know. Hopefully someone will buy a bike from me. Anyway, talk to you later. Okay, just putting the camera on quickly just to say I still haven't found that last V-brake. And I've looked everywhere. I only found three suitable front mechs to go on there. Yeah. I'm going to start calling them mechs because it's a lot easier than Dralia. So, yeah, but none of those three actually fit, so I'm going to have to find one. Still need seat post, gear shifters, handlebar grips, and a chain. Once I've got those parts, I can throw on the cables. Oh yeah, and brake levers. If I choose grip shifts. If I choose trigger shifters, then they're usually built into the brake lever as one unit, so... couple of tubes there I'm going to pump up to see if they're punctured. If they're not, they'll go straight in the wheel. If they are, then I'm going to fix the punctures. I'm actually going to check that box under there just to make sure I haven't done something daft and threw that V-brake I need in there. I've cleared up down there, thinking, you know, I may have dropped on the floor, but I've not seen it. Looked underneath both desks, there's nothing under there. Excuse me. And you can't miss something that's that colour, can you? Look at it. It's the whole reason I nicked them off that other bike. Because they look nice. That is the only reason. That spring needs adjusting, it's a bit... It's not very powerful. I'll just adjust the screw. Oh well. I think some parts I may end up getting new, such as the gear shifters. I was going to put a baggage rack on this, but I'm not sure if this has got the space to do it. Anyway, I want to just pop to... Unfortunately, I've got to pop to Lidl and Sainsbury's. I'd rather not, but I don't have a choice. So I feel like grilling up some chicken. Oh, you moved in here now, have you? excuse me. So I'll go and do that, have something to eat, and I'll have another search around for that poxy break. At least if I can bolt that on and get it on, get it sat on two inflated tyres, that would actually get the bike to the point where I can't actually do any more to it. Not without the other parts. I can't put any cables on because I don't have anything to attach them to. Well, I suppose I can't even adjust the handlebars to the where I want them because I haven't got a seat to sit on. I need to see, you know, what feels comfortable. It may even be comfortable where it is, but... I've got this long bit of cable out of here, because I'll need that. And I've got another bit in the bedroom. Oh yeah, and quickly, Wiggles, give me another bike light. Look at this one. It's another... I've already got one of these. Got one of these on my French three-speed bike downstairs, which... when the weather does actually get a bit better, I'll pull it out and pump the tyres up. Yeah, this works. I've put my own battery in it. That does all work nicely. But it takes a battery, which is extremely hard to get hold of these days. One of those square ones, 4.5 volt. Yeah, I've had this one for a while, as you can tell, because all the paper covering is all... Yeah. But the one I've got on my French bike, someone's converted it to use two AA batteries. I think it was two, anyway. If I can get to it when I lock my bike up later, I'll bring the light up and show you. Because I'll probably do the same to that one. Right, I think that is it for now. I know Nemo's got food in his dish, I've already done him. Right, I'm gonna go get something to eat, so adios for now. Right, well, I want to get in a bath in a minute, but I figured I'd go downstairs and just lock that girl's bike up. And actually, before I show you that, I has a photograph. In a second, it's... It's standing all by magic. Nah, there's an adjustable spanner just in there, being used as a temporary stand. But there, that's the girl's one. That's up for sale. No interest yet, but to be honest, for a Saturday and Saturday night, I didn't expect it. Oops, I minimised it, not closed it. We'll just have one more quick check, but I doubt it. Nope. Short answer to that one. Right. I've also just dragged a bicycle upstairs, and it's this one. Quite a nice looking one, isn't it? It's a Magna brand, and it's a Outcast. Yeah, that's just decorative graphics there. It'll clean up nice. You can see what I mean by the sort of downhill jump sort of styled bike. I'm not sure if that's the right wheel. I've got to count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I think. Hang on. Yeah, so I've got to put a 7-speed freewheel on that wheel. Well, it's either I'll do that, or I'll put a 6-speed grip shift on it. Because as you can see, half of this is missing. But I do have a good matching pair of 7-speed shifters, so I think it would actually be easier just to change that freewheel to a 7-speed, which I've got down in the shed. Fixed a puncture, whack a handlebar in there because I stole it. I did actually steal it. And the seat, I stole it for the ladies' bike I just showed you. I've got a seat I can whack on it. Hello. Got black that side. Chrome this side. Pedals still match, so I could just go over both with some black paint if I really want to, or just leave them as they is and just mention it in the ad. It's not affecting the bike, is it? The same length, same style, same Magna brand pedal, it's just one's chrome and one's matte black. Should have a front derailleur I could whack on this. That looks a fairly standard sized tube there. And I do believe... Yes. No. Yes, no. Maybe. Oh. Oh. Oh, that's going to be awkward. This isn't meant to have front gears. Bugger. So I've got a funny feeling someone's changed the crank then. Right. Well, that's throwing a spanner in the works. I didn't know that when I bought it. I'm guessing someone bent the single speed crank on it and they've replaced it with a... Well, that actually looks like a brand spanking new 3-speed one. I couldn't even dismantle that because actually if I could only do the rear gears on this, that would make life a bit easier. I've just got to worry about brakes. See, I've got a single speed crank, but I actually wanted that for another job. Fuck. is what I can say about. I was hoping... Well, that explains why I can't actually see a mark where a front derailleur was mounted, because I'm guessing it never had one. A poo is what I've got to say to that. Right. Well, that's completely thrown a spanner in the plan. I don't want to separate the good pair of grip shifts I've got. It's one of the few good matches I've got. And... I'd like to use that on another bike, so I may have to just go into my box of grip shifts and put a 6-speed on there. Because I do believe I've got some odd 6-speeds in there. So I can just throw a replacement one on there, a couple of brake levers. It'll be good to go. Then I've got to sort that crank out. And how the hell am I going to do that? Don't think you can dismantle these ones. No. It doesn't look like it. Fudge. It looks like I'll have to use the other single speed crank I've got. Just give them a fresh coat of black paint just to freshen them up. Fudge. Now that's completely thrown a spanner in the works for Cat's Custom Trikes racing bike I've still got to do, because a cock crank was being a pain in the ass, so I was going to put a single speed front mountain bike crank on it, but yeah, bollocks is what I can say to that. Never mind, I'll think of something else for Cat's Custom Trikes racing bike. Something may come in down the dump. I was actually hoping I'd sell a bike today so I could stop off at the dump tomorrow, but never mind. It'll have to be next weekend, I guess, unless I go over during the week. Could get Mum if she wants to. She'll be working Thursday, so if she wanted to come uptown after she's finished work. I don't mind slinging a bit of fuel in the car. Anyway, I'm going to go and get a bath. I just want to disappoint myself, I think. Disappoint myself in the sense that this is only capable of taking rear gears. Oh, I can't even modify it because I need one of these. There's only that one on the frame, and then the one for the rear brake. That is it. So I'm guessing this is a jump-style bike, but yeah. You see these match the brakes I put on my Claud? Because this is where the brakes came from. I stolen them. Because I like them. I still haven't found that missing one. You know, it's... 8:35 in the evening now, and I still haven't found that poxy missing one. I've searched, I don't know how many boxes. I've tipped that one out and whatnot, and I still can't find the stupid thing. Never mind. Oh, these tubes are stayed up, so I'll do these after a bath, probably. Or tomorrow, or whenever, I don't know. Right, bath time. Tyres have stayed inflated. Tubes have stayed inflated. But it's too late for me to bang around putting those in the wheels now. Might have someone come and collect that lady's bike very early in the morning. If not, I said I can take it with me to Mum's and they can collect from there if easier. Yeah. An intruder alarm went off in a building over the back there. Couldn't see anything, so... And guess what? I still not found that poxy brake. Oh, I don't know where it is. It's doing my nut in now. I've looked every bloody way and I can't find it. Well, what a cat's problem is, he's got a dish full of food. It's a part I would have needed, so I know I wouldn't have hidden it anywhere. Or put it up. I'd have put it somewhere obvious. And as Mum said earlier on the phone, I've probably looked at it like 10 fucking times. Oh! There's one of the grip shifts I was talking about. One of the ones that I don't want to put on this one. Won't be far away. One of these days, I'll find somewhere to put that poxy VCR as well. Mind you, oddly enough, I haven't tripped over it that many times. Right. My camera, the other camera. Pardon me. Yeah, I've all looked through there. Nope. Nothing shining red. Well, I'd call it a red colour anyway. Fallen down the back of that, the gap isn't big enough. No, can't see it. I found my web camera. Is it up there, is it? Nope. If I actually stop looking for it and start looking for something else, that's when I'll find a damn thing. It's annoying. Oh well. Bloody way. Nope. pretty certain it's not on the top of this. No, I'm not there either. Hello. Bike bits. Nuts. Here. Anything I can make use of? A left hand one. I don't want a left hand one, not for this bike. What we got? Ooh! A pair of handlebar grips. They will come in handy for this one. What is that one? That's a 6-speed. There we go. Got me a gear shifter for that. Don't mind separating that style because I've got shed loads of them down in the shed. In the box down there. And I mean shed loads. So I can soon make a pair up, so I'll use one of those for that bike. I might actually turf the linen basket out because I wouldn't be surprised if I've chucked it on the top there or it's fallen on the top. Or something bloody just as daft. Nope, I thought that would have been down there. Oh well. I'll have a better look when I've got two hands free, so. Turn that light off for now. Said it can't be that far away. I've not taken that anywhere apart from the flat, so it's got to be up here somewhere. Because I bought all four up here. I know I had all four. I know for a fact I bought all four back. Didn't I shit brick? Right, we'll disappear then. See if they reply in regards to that lady's bike and see what they want to do. I can take it to Mum's, not a problem. If it's going to make it easier for them, because I'm going to be there till late afternoon anyway, so. No reply yet. Spam! What have we got in the spam folder? When Yahoo has done effing about. Oh, I've got two from the same person. Now, why does Yahoo always put these replies in spam? It never used to. Never used to. Right. Time for me to go, I think, as it's 11:30 at night, so thanks for watching. I'm going to play a bit of this, possibly some GTA, and bugger off to bed. So, yeah, thanks for watching. Don't forget to give me a like. Much appreciated. The thumb commands you. Yeah, I've got a fucking clue what I'm doing. Subscribe if you want to. And, you know, hit the like button if you only if you want to. And I'll talk to you all again soon. Bye-bye.